As a small business owner, you deserve more. More confidence, more connectivity, more of the tools that help your business thrive. And at Cox Business, you can expect more from us. We don't just have sales reps. We have perfect plan identifiers, people who will work with you to make sure your business gets everything it needs and nothing that it doesn't. Your business deserves more, and that's why you can expect more from Cox Business. Call 800-526-8572 to switch today.
There's nothing more predictable in life than the unexpected. Lightning will always strike. Hail will fall on roofs. Fortunately, there's AAA. AAA has been helping members stay prepared for over 100 years. So when unusual storms, fallen debris, or sudden leaks happen, you'll be covered. Check, check, and check. Get the home and auto insurance you need by talking with a AAA insurance agent today. Visit AAA.com/insurance or stop by your local AAA store.
If you prefer real mornings, shouldn't you have a real breakfast? At McDonald's, we get real about breakfast. That's why you can have a savory sausage biscuit with delicious hash browns for only $1.50. It's time to wake up breakfast. Single item at regular price. Prices and participation may vary. Cannot be combined with any other offer or combo meal.
Thoughts of suicide may feel impossible to overcome, but with help and support, you can find hope and meaning. Call the National Suicide Prevention Lifeline at 1-800-273-TALK to speak to a counselor, or visit suicidepreventionlifeline.org. It's free, it's confidential, it's available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. And even if it feels like it, you are not alone.
My son was in the Army back during Desert Storm, but even then he wanted an MBA. He looked at a dozen schools, but only one offered the online education and flexibility he needed while he was in a tent in Iraq, Grantham University. Turns out that Grantham's been delivering a four.
Studios right here on KLRN Radio. And with me, as always, is the only Amish guy whose 10-gallon hat holds 20 gallons. Gordy Pack. Gordy, how are you?
Well, yeah, but it's, you know, more like 10 pounds of shit in a 5-pound bag.
That's way more information than I ever needed to know.
How are you doing for Blue Bar evening?
I'm leaking.
You're leaking?
I'm
allergies?
Leaking. I don't know. It's my right eye, and bizarre things I have a lost tear duct. Yeah, it's like what babies get. So I have like a baby thing going on. It's better though. Like I was like always crying like 3 days ago. People were like, "What the hell's wrong with you? Are you fat?" I'm like, "I don't cry." You know, but I'm like leaking like crazy. And now it just kind of leaks if I get too hairy or like, well, if it's possible. I think it's better. It's like a creepy thing that only infants usually get, or like really babies. So that's not good.
Kind of like shingles?
I guess so, yeah. It's kind of like my shingles thing, but it's a leaky eye. And it's like a gross thing, you know? You can not even like it's something. That's, yeah, my eyes are leaking. I can't even make up a good story, you know?
According to Chad, you've got the Rona.
I got the Rona in the eye. That's what my husband thinks. He's like, you got the Rona. It's going to go great. Shit's going to fall out of my forehead, you know?
You got bad AIDS in the eye.
I got the AIDS of the eyeball. Tell you what. No, I'm just like, what the hell is it? I'm like, why am I leaking? And I'm like, I'm not crying. I don't cry. I'm not capable of tears. But it's so gross. Aren't you glad you asked? Yes, it's such a great topic to talk about my leaking organs and body parts. Yay! This is what happens when you get like over 45. All the shit's like breaking and leaking and squeaking and cracking and popping. Yay! It's so much fun.
Yeah, I know. I get out of bed, I sound like a 21-gun salute.
So like, yay! Look at that. Yes. No. How are you? Are you good?
Everything is well out in here and the lockdown state of California. How you doing out in your lockdown state of...
Hey, man, we are in phase one. We ate pizza at a restaurant. We were outside, of course, in the patio, but damn it, I paid someone to serve. It was fantastic. We bought furniture this weekend.
Did you buy it from the Amish? Did you buy it from my Amish brethren?
I did not. We went totally, like, evil corporate capitalism, but it was a beautiful bed for my son. No, fuck IKEA. No, and it was just like another furniture shop, and he picked out a bed because there's lights on it. I'm like, he's my son. He's so much my son. Why do you like it? It lights up. Okay, we're done. You know, but no.
Is it Alexa enabled?
Oh no, I know better than that because I've seen what's happening with you and your Alexa. We need to talk about your problem and this inappropriate relationship you have with the device.
It's entirely appropriate. Don't judge my love.
Oh, but it's just, it's awkward. You know, remember your issues with Alexa. Anytime she hears you on the air, especially with a female, your power goes off, your air conditioning blows up.
Internet goes out.
You know, she's kind of a possessive, crazy bitch. I'm just saying. Thinking about your safety here. I don't want to see a boiling rabbit.
All of this comes from... Uh-huh. I just...
Go
you
ahead.
Know what?
Make an excuse. Tell them why you have a weird relationship with a device.
Okay. All the time we were growing up, we were promised we would have these, you know, voice-controlled assistants. Well, because building computers isn't really a job anymore because they're so cheap and disposable, I have found my next venue into craftiness with woodworking and incorporating technology into it. So like self-opening drawers and TV lifts and all of it voice control, because all the components are there now.
Uh-huh.
So this is my new hobby.
Wow, that sounds really interesting.
That's condescending little brat.
Super awesome. Wow.
Don't leak out your eyes some more.
I can't. I wish you would stop. It's so annoying. Like, I'm playing Animal Crossing now. I know that's like super mature, but I started playing Animal Crossing and my daughter's like the Animal Crossing wizard or something. But I started playing and I look down and I'm like tearing up trying to play this different game.
So Animal Crossing makes you cry is what you're saying.
I just want to sell
my become such an emotional wreck.
I just want to sell
from the lockdown.
Turnips. I don't want to cry because my eye's leaking. But no, it's fine. If you want to have a strange relationship with a device,
normal. Don't judge my love.
I can't help
it. Don't judge me. Don't kink shame me.
That's like my whole thing. Kink shame. Oh my God. Anyway, TMI. Speaking of kink shame, that kind of segues into my Stacey Abrams piece.
Oh God.
Stacey Abrams. The Washington Post wrote this very interesting article. They Beyonce'd her, made her really this superhero woman. She's really not. And I even went out, look at me, how organized I am. I took part of the story out to read to everyone just in case they missed it. Because this is really important because it looks like Biden might be picking her, which is terrifying. But anyway, this is from the article the Washington Post wrote about Stacey Abrams. They wrote, this is basically right before she comes on stage or when she's first come on stage to speak. They wrote, pandemonium ensues as she walks to the far left of the stage, like a runway supermodel, stops on a dime, poses, tilts her head slightly, and smiles. Camera flashes explode. Keep in mind, this is Washington Post, not some weird, you know, president fan club.
And this is Stacey Abrams, not some
This is not a supermodel. Anyway, she next pivots and walks slowly to the center of the stage, freezes there, and repeats the pose. I don't know if I can read this whole thing. Again, the flashes explode. Abrams is summoning her inner actress, and she is both enjoying the moment and getting through it to get to the conversation. I cannot believe they wrote this shit. She then pivots. She's pivoted twice now. And walks to the far right of the stage. Same. You wonder whether she has done this before, because it's not necessarily what women expect from a 46-year-old politician. She's my age. Holy shit. Anyway, blah, 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 blah. She also happens to predict that she'll be elected president by 2040, yada, yada, yada. So the whole piece reads like this. And they have this really weird, if you haven't seen it, the photo that they use with Stacey Abrams' piece is she looks like Godzilla. Framed with all this smoke around her. And she's all, of course, shadowed out. It is the dumbest thing they could have done with her picture.
Yeah, that's not the look they were going for, but it's a photo that launched 1,000 memes.
It is so bad. It is, you know, and...
They went for the superhero thing because she's got a cape on and kind of silhouetted against a white light with kind of like a Dark City look. But, yeah, it just... Oh, God, the cringe.
It's so bad.
The cringe is too strong.
Here's the thing. You know, and what's really happening is, you know, they call her a supermodel. So all the people are like super size models, plus size model. You know, she's really getting hammered about her size, which is not necessarily her fault. But, you know, you can't do that. You can't go out there and make her a caricature and then expect people to go not make fun of her. I mean, that's what they've done. They've set her up.
One of the best ones I saw was... It had her and then kind of like the bat signal going up, and the comment was, wow, Batman has really let himself go.
Yeah, I saw that one. And you see the one where Biden is behind her, and he's got his hands on her shoulder, and he's like smelling her.
Have
oh my God, it freaked. It's not good. It's not good. And then, of course, they did the Japanese writing down the side of her leg, you know, and it's like the whole Godzilla poster with the little girl in front of her.
Right.
It's so bad.
People running down the street as she's silhouetted against a cityscape. Yeah.
And they're all looking, and they've had her as the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man was another one I saw.
Yeah.
Yeah, not good. What did
this is one of those... One of those ill-conceived ideas. I mean, it probably sounded really good in a pitch meeting. It's like that I'm with Joe meme.
Yeah.
Remember that? Where it was like you could create your own, you know, I'm with Joe. So, like, I made one with a potato. And
Yeah. It was like one with chains and, you know, like, for the hair because he's a sniffer. You know, it was bad. I don't know who is telling these people this is a great idea. I just can't see that meeting. You know what we should do, guys? We should totally make Stacey Abrams into this giant figure covered in smoke and she's silhouetted. And I just don't get it. It's one thing to talk about, hey, this is why we think Stacey Abrams should be Biden's vice president. XYZ. But they're really trying to make her into something that she's not. And it feels very fake and forced. And I think it'll do more harm than good at this point.
It's that don't ever put a celebrity or a politician next to a white sign in a photo.
No.
Because it's going to get changed. It's going to get changed.
It's going to get fucked with. I mean, that's what happened.
Yeah. It's like how the Crowder changed my mind meme.
Yeah.
Became a thing. And it's just so many times. It's every time they're doing something in the Senate with a whiteboard, that whiteboard becomes, it launches 1,000 memes.
It does indeed. And I don't know if you know Tim Young or not. He's a comedian and he's a writer. Tim wrote actually a pretty funny tweet about, you know, I can't believe this is supermodel something Beyonce. MoveOn.org decides to go after him. They basically threaten him. They call him Junior. Like, that's going to shut him down. I'm like, hello, you don't know Tim. He doubles down.
I think they were responding to Junior because Trump Jr. wasn't, but still.
But it seems funny again, either way, right?
Learn to Twitter, reply to the right person.
Or shut up. And don't threaten people.
Don't threaten people.
You should know there's a people here with moral virus or crap. It was like they were trying to say, you better be careful because we're the good guys and you're going to get it. And it was so dumb.
You're on the wrong side of history.
Here's the thing about Move On is they were originally founded to get people to stop talking about Bill Clinton being a rapist. So, yay. They all
wasn't it to get people to move on from the impeachment?
That too. It was all of it. Move on from all of the shit that Clinton did. the rape, the blue dress, the impeachment. Move on. Look at that.
Move on. Yeah.
Move on. Yeah. So they were founded basically to give Bill Clinton a pass.
Right.
And now they're lecturing other people on morality. So that's funny. Yeah.
Yeah. Somebody commented to me today too about in my reply to Move On about how they're almost as worse as MMFA. And I said, well, they're the same people.
They really are.
Yeah. They are. They were. Yeah. They're both MOOC organizations.
Yep, they really are.
So,
well, it's kind of like the OFA group too. They're all in that same world. Obama's, what was it, Organizing for America? Those are all kind of the same people that have just branched out in various ways.
Sure.
These groups, and you're going to see them a lot as we get closer to the election. They are out there in full force doing what they do, which is
creating bad memes,
being really annoying, trying to create chaos. We're going to pick at people, especially in the conservative movement, who have any kind of following or voice. They're going to try and take everything apart, and it's going to get really bad before it gets better. But that's what they do. And what's fun is we all know who they are, so we just kind of make fun of them at this point, which helps. But the Stacey Abrams thing just stunk of all of this to me. They're all working together to make it where she's going to be his pick. And what terrifies me even further is that we all know if some reason Biden wins, that he's not going to be president. He's just not. Even if it's like 2 months, he's done. And then what, Stacey? Holy shit. No.
Yeah.
No.
Well, she'd have to give up governorship of Georgia first.
Yeah, she'd have to resign her whole governor thing. But that's terrifying to me that they want her for some reason. I don't understand even what she has to bring to the table. I mean, it's okay. She checks off little boxes. Is that it? What else has she done that's worth a damn? I just don't get it.
It's not. It's a, what was it? Who was, somebody made a comment yesterday that, Stacey Abrams is really becoming the Sarah Palin of the, Democrats. I said, nah, cause Sarah Palin won an election.
At least Sarah had already been a governor. That's a good
right.
point.
Right. Yeah.
Sarah had done something.
Yeah.
But the
thing is, this is what fascinates me, is that who are they sandbagging for? You know Biden isn't going to get the nomination. I mean, sure, he'll get the delegates in the first round, but because of the Rona, they didn't get to have all the primaries and,
Rona.
You know, there's all those, you know.
Yeah.
All those delegates just sitting out there that, I mean, even the DNC spokeswoman said the other day that, hey, we haven't nominated Biden yet.
Yeah, and I think that they're just kind of biding their time. I really don't know what.
Hey,
look at me. I'm making old people jokes. That's awesome, yeah,
that,
right?
That was clever.
I'm leaking and making old people jokes. It's over. Put me away. I'm done. I retired.
Somebody put the Biden sniffing Stacey Abrams in
oh
the.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, Rooster's quick. He took the old I'm on Team awesome. Joe meme and put the new meme in it.
Look at that.
So, yeah.
Talent. But I think that is.
We have very talented chat.
The chat sucks. But that is probably, I think, the worst and most cringy of all the memes I saw of that today was him with his hands around her. Ugh, this just makes me so bad.
Her
so bad.
Down. Yeah.
It's cringy. Like,
the whole thing is cringy.
Like this Chris Chaliza thing. Look at that. Another one. So, did you see what happened with Chris Chaliza today?
Chrisilla, going from Godzilla to Chrisilla.
Chizilla, yeah, Chrisilla.
Chris Chizilla. Yeah, oh yeah, no, he achieved in doing what previously only MSN could do, that is get drugged by the left.
Oh my, well, he gets drugged a lot, but today was bad. Bad, bad. It was all based on the idea of what James Woods said in his praise of Trump. And James Woods, of course, said, here are the things that kind of suck about Trump. You know, he's raw, he can be insensitive, he's self-centered. You know, he said basically what we know about Trump. But then he said, but nobody loves America or Americans more than he does, and he's the best president I've had in my lifetime, yada, yada, yada. So, of course, the media tries to pull out the chunk where he says bad things and go, hey, look, this is not a good thing, because Trump thanked James for his tweet. I think James got what, you know, Trump got what James was saying. Well, Chris writes his entire piece about James' praise. And he really doesn't say he's right. He really doesn't say that Trump's a good guy. He does call him, was it, he's an unreliable jerk who gets things done. And he really never once says a nice thing about Trump. And he even says in the article, if you read it, that he thinks that Trump's path to winning again is very narrow. Like he never says anything good. The left lost their GD minds on Twitter. And it was really because of the headline about the unreliable or unlikable. It's unlikable jerk is what he said.
Sure.
And so they lose their minds. If you look at anything he had to say today, all you see are people are, you've lost your mind. And why are people still paying you? And of course it goes into, they should fire you. You're a piece of shit. You know, they always go that route.
Yeah. Yeah. How do you have a job? And yeah.
How are you?
Which
still
we wonder
paid?
Too, yeah, but fair. You know, we at least have a legitimate gripe.
Hey, you know, we kind of agree with you. Why is this asshole still getting paid?
But you know, hey, you know what? Who knew that CNN could heal the political divide of America?
Look at
we
this
all
wrong,
wonder
man.
How they're employed. Essie Cup, Cater, Chris Zilla.
Oh, my God.
K-File, how are they employed? We all wonder this.
We all wonder this. And yeah.
Let the healing begin.
And none of us believe they're essential. So, woo, here we go.
Right, exactly.
Oh, my God. That made me leak anymore. But anyway, I was reading through them today, and I'm like, none of these assholes read the article because they're just screaming at him. You know, have you, why are you so broken? We knew you were a traitor, blah, you know. And of course, he's
Trump shill, blah, blah, blah. Yeah.
Trump shill. Oh, yeah. Then, of course, we had to hear how the media helps Trump all the time, which was hilarious.
Yeah, of course they do. You know, yeah, because nobody's more Republican than MSNBC and CNN.
Oh, totally. They're on his side all the time.
Usually it's just the goddamn commies who say that shit, but this was just rank and file hillbots, too.
People lost their shit. And I'm just like, there's no way you guys read the article. Because if you read the article, you realize he's talking more about why people agree with James Woods when they talk about how much they like the president. They will say, yeah, I don't necessarily care for X, Y, Z, but, and there's a but always there, he does all this other crap, and he does it well, and he gets it done. And so that's the whole point of the story. It's not that he's like, yeah, he's a jerk, but he gets shit done. He never really says that. He says, this is why Trump has this base. It's because they might think he's a total asshole, but he gets stuff done. And that's the whole point. None of them read it. All they did was scream at it. It was the funniest damn thing I think I've seen today.
Yeah, no, that was great.
It was a lot of fun. Yeah. I like watching them eat each other. It's kind of
Let them fight.
Let them. What's with all Godzilla stuff?
Let it happen. I know. What is with all the Godzilla stuff tonight?
Makes you wonder, doesn't it? First, we have Stacey Abrams, and then we move into Chris Godzilla. And
you know, fortunately, we've got the Asian murder hornets because Godzilla hates those.
Oh, yeah. That will keep us safe. That and the Rona.
That and the Rona.
Rona. Oh, please, no. Did you hear? This was like weeks ago, maybe months ago, when Weird Al was talking about how he refused to make a song about Rona.
I didn't.
He wouldn't do my Bologna. He wouldn't do my Corona. He wouldn't do, you know, Yoda as Rona. None of that. He made a whole big joke about how he won't do it because this shit is not funny. Which was funny.
This shit ain't funny, which was kind of funny.
That's funny, you know. But yeah, he refused to do like my Corona. Corona.
Didn't he already do my Sharona with another song? I don't know.
He did my Bologna.
There you go. So he's already done it. It's the same reason why he can't do Lola. He's already done it.
Yoda, how could you not know my Bologna?
Well, I knew.
Amish.
Yeah, because he did Yoda to Lola. Right.
Y-O-D-A-Y-O-D-A.
And he did my Bologna to my Sharona. So there's all the songs that rhyme with Corona.
That's it.
Aside from the Minimum song, I just had a Corona 5-cent deposit, which is the only, you know, time it's mentioned in. It's the theme song to Jackass.
I got you. That's great.
You got
that's
it? You picking up what I'm putting down? No, yeah.
Fascinating. But no, that was totally off topic.
Your ex or a bitch.
Oh, you're lucky I love your mother. Okay. That was a your mom joke waiting.
Your mother too, Jackass.
I know. Damn it. It makes it so hard. But yeah, those are my, I actually had those things actually like totally organized and stuff. Look at that.
Yeah.
I even put down stuff to read. I couldn't read the whole thing, though. I get too bored. I have the attention span of a squirrel, but worse.
Yeah. Have a like, chat squirrel.
Yeah, it's bad. And we have one in chat that figures. But I do have other things listed. I think we have time for the CVS piece that we. You
oh,
have.
Do we? Because
we
that's,
do. Okay. We have at least 5 minutes. Come on.
You want to hold that? Because I got a quick hit.
Go ahead. If you got a quick one, go for it.
Yeah. So my Governor Newsom. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Who also I found out today his wife is not the First Lady of California.
No.
She is the first partner of California.
Oh, well, that's good. You know, right. That's what matters.
Yeah, that's what matters. So anyway, he's holding the state. He's holding the citizens of California hostage. He's saying if he does not get his federal money, which has he already spent all the other federal money, and which he's in a lawsuit right now because he wants to give $750 million of the federal money to illegal aliens. Okay. But now he's saying if he doesn't get more money from the government, the first people that are going to be let go are first responders.
Whoa, really?
And this is what he always does. He always uses teachers, first responders, and firefighters as his political
bargaining chips.
If I don't get what I want, I'm just going to have to let these people go.
And you then know, people will
die. And then people will die. And, you know, not the army of bureaucrats or the people building the fucking roads. You know, no, it's always the first responders or the teachers.
Oh, dude, that's awful.
Yeah.
Man, see, yeah. They're opening Virginia Beach this weekend, you know, and like Northam's acting like he had a choice. But anyway, he's opening the beach this weekend. Right. He starts talking about, now you guys be responsible when you get on this beach and it's 50% capacity and we have beach ambassadors and shit.
Which is like our business ambassadors.
Right. They don't get, they're like, whatever, just do your shit. So he has all these rules, no alcohol, no umbrellas, no groups, no sports, but you can go and be on the beach. And 50% capacity, blah, 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 blah. And he starts lecturing us about how if we get out of line, he might be forced to take that away. And I said, no, fuck you. That is not happening.
So, we've talked about this. This is why when the Rona comes back around in the fall,
yep,
there will be zero compliance among the population.
Not happening. And we're seeing it already. We're seeing it here. Just as they open up phase one and people are kind of like leaving their home, you hear da 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 da. You know, they come out. It's like, oh, it's beautiful. People are not wearing masks. People are doing what they want to do. Clearly, Virginia Beach was packed this last weekend. So, like, he pretends he's giving us permission. Like, we took it. We're going. So, it was funny. Well, if you misbehave, we're going to take it away from you again.
It's like Gaddafi's line in the sand. If you cross this line and you die.
You die.
Okay, well, if you cross this line, you die.
You cross that line, you die.
Okay, you cross this line, I close my door and I don't come out.
Yeah, here we go. Nobody's scared. But that's terrible.
On the other end of it, Newsom did say that we will likely have spectator-free sports in the state by July. Dallas Cowboys training camp can go on.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
We're seeing that, too. Florida's talking about that. There's a couple of other states. Of course, New York all of a sudden wants to be involved, too. Like, really, guys? I don't think so.
Yeah.
But I could see that. And I think we need that. They're talking about baseball starting July 6th. Of course, it will be, you know, no crowds. But they're at least talking about these things happening, which is more than what we've had. So we'll take it.
Right. Yeah.
Then you did see what happened with Oregon. And the governor there, she got bitch-slapped by a judge.
Yeah, I saw that. And here's the thing. It's like when you're so authoritarian, you forget to even have a presumption of law and order.
Yeah.
And her 28-day, according to Oregon Constitution, you cannot suspend rights for more than 28 days unless you have legislative approval.
Yeah.
And she never sought that approval. So
she did not. She's done.
So a circuit court judge said, yeah, get fucked.
Yep, and that happens. It's also happening in Wisconsin. They're getting jumped. They're getting dumped there. CNN wrote this shitty article, and I know we need to go to break, but they wrote this article about how the evil Republicans who have, you know, a majority are forcing people out of their homes. I'm like, you guys are fucked in the head. These people want to get out. No one has said, if you have to leave your house, if you don't want to, stay home.
Right.
But, yeah, I think we can go over this crap when we get back from break.
Sure.
Can we take a break?
Yeah, let's take a break.
Okay, we're going to take a break. We're going to be on about 2-3 minutes. So you guys hang out and chat, say mean things about Ordy, and we'll be right back. Thanks for being here tonight, guys.
If you My son was in the Army back during Desert Storm, but even then he wanted an MBA. He looked at a dozen schools, but only one offered the online education and flexibility he needed while he was in a tent in Iraq, Grantham University. Turns out that Grantham's been delivering affordable, relevant college and advanced degrees for over 65 years. Heck, if they can deliver a quality education to a soldier in a tent overseas, think about the flexibility Grantham can offer you so you can earn your degree too. It doesn't matter how complicated or full your life is, if getting a degree is on your bucket list, you'll want to do what my son did. You'll want to call Grantham. Find out how easy it is to get started on your education so you can check that college degree off your bucket list. Call Grantham right now. 800-910-1370. That's 800-910-1370. Flexible, affordable, relevant. Call 800-910-1370.
Tired of paying outrageous prices for Viagra? Well, we have great news for you. Now you can finally get Viagra at huge discounts. Healthy Man allows you to save up to $500 on Viagra. Why pay U.S. pharmacy prices of $15 per pill or more when you can get Viagra for less than $3 a pill? Call today and get 40 Viagra pills for only $99. This can cost as much as $600 at your local pharmacy. You can't afford not to call us. If you want Viagra at the lowest prices, never pay $15 a pill pharmacy prices again. Get Viagra for less than $3 a pill. Call 1-800-516-7602 today and save up to $500 and get 40 pills for just $99. Healthy Man is fast, easy, and affordable. Operators are waiting at 1-800-516-7602 to take your call right now. Call 1-800-516-7602. That's 1-800-516-7602. Again, 1-800-516-7602.
Attention business owners and independent contractors. This is a money-saving message from Tax Mediation Services. If your business owes $20,000 or more in taxes, we can help you today, right now. Listen, dealing with the IRS is no picnic. It's an intimidating and extremely stressful process, and you don't want to go it alone. Our attorneys know every law, every tax break, and every possible opportunity to help you resolve and reduce your tax debt. And if you owe more than $20,000, you may be at the top of their hit list. So don't take your tax debt lightly, because it will not go away on its own. The IRS can seize your bank accounts, your home, and even shut down your business. Call our tax experts today at 1-800-783-0810 and let us deal with the IRS while you focus on your business. That's 1-800-783-0810. Again, that's 800-783-0810.
And we're back from break. Thank you for staying put, guys. You are here with FluBar on KLRN Radio, as we're doing every Monday night until the entire country is at least in phase one and not locked down in their homes. And yeah, the Amish guy is still with me. You're there, right, Ordy?
I might as well be.
Yeah, what else are you going to do?
Despite all the abuse and your leaking all over the place.
God, you know, it is gross. But I'm sorry. If you expect no abuse, you're on the wrong show.
Sure.
If you want nice, you're talking to the wrong girl. But anyway, right. Thanks for being here, guys. Again, we are doing our special flu bar series until this flu is gone, or at least under control, right?
Flu, I'm getting a little feedback.
I don't think we're getting it now.
Okay, good. All right, yeah, let's go.
No, I have a little, but it's not the end of the world. Can you hear me? Right. You guys getting any feedback in chat? Yeah, I got it. That's a lot. Hello.
Hello.
Hello. You know, it wouldn't be FluBar if we weren't getting some kind of echoing going on or something.
Well, hey, I mean, usually it's better. In my head, but yeah.
I got some echo, yeah.
A little bit.
A little bit. All right. I think we're good. Yeah, I think Lou, did you fix it? I think maybe. Gosh. Maybe.
Anyway.
I don't know. Anyway, we can talk through it.
So CBS.
CBS. Yeah, CBS is fun. So earlier today, One of the challenges of writing any kind of media or being any kind of right leaning media is we have to really look through a lot of things that come our way. And sometimes you see something that you think to yourself, there's no way that's true. There's no way this is really happening. And if, of course, the account comes to you and they have less than 100 followers and you don't know them and they sell you this crazy stuff, you think, I'm not touching that. But I'll tell you this. Today, this morning, this account came to me with something on CBS that I honestly couldn't believe when I saw it. And this was talking about the mystery illness that is apparently attacking children that is associated with COVID. Because, you know, we can't be okay with the idea that kids are not being impacted with COVID. So they're going to bring in something else to scare the shit out of us. So they bring in this mystery illness. And there's a photograph of these babies' legs, and they're covered in these pink dots. And this photo apparently is from a Ukrainian story from like 4 years ago. So, we're looking at it, and I think to myself, there's no way this is real. It's so bad. This can't be real. And then, of course, Ordy finds the other feed and sends me the link, and we were able to watch the feed, and it's indeed real. CBS used a bad photo or a fake photo or an old photo of these babies' legs and to say this is what this mystery illness looks like.
Yeah, it was a unrelated photo would be the best way to put it. It's yeah, it's they did a report on this mystery illness, and this came to us from one of our followers, and I had no reason to doubt. But the thing is that the other site that had it was a Ukrainian site, so that kind of but then as you dig into it, you're like, oh hey, that's real. And so yeah, that caused a whole bunch of fun in our mentions today.
Well, it was interesting because, and I understand not wanting to necessarily take it seriously, because when you see something that blatant and that obnoxious, you think to yourself, there's no way that this can possibly be real. There's no way that an outlet would seek this low. But they did. So CBS does this whole thing, and they have all these photographs of different kids and different spots and all these things. And you're thinking, oh, this is terrible. And then you realize the photo that at least one of the photos is not, has nothing to do with the actual mystery illness. It is like, what was it called? Coxsackie virus. What is it?
Yeah, it's a common childhood virus that I'm terrible at pronouncing things, but it's named after a small town on the in upper state New York. And it coming from CBS, that's the least surprising thing of it, because they're the ones who have used footage from an Italian hospital saying that it was New York City, apologized because it was just poorly edited, some mistake from a junior editor until they did it again.
Right.
And then you had the thing with Project Veritas last week where they got
I forgot about that.
Yeah, when they got them stacking the decks on a line for vaccinations.
Yeah, I forgot about that.
Yeah, and then you have this where they're using a four-year-old story. And it wasn't even a relate. The more research I did into it, it wasn't even a related thing. It's like the one that happened in Ukraine is bacterial, where the one that happens in the United States is viral. And while the one in the United States is the one that the kids are getting now who have had COVID is similar to it, it's still not that viral. It's like that somebody at CBS just said, I need a picture of a kid with a rash.
Yep. And they went out and found a screenshot of something and they used it. And what's interesting is the original article is written in, is it Ukrainian or Russian? And you look at it.
Yeah, it's in Russian.
Well, and you look at it. And you think, wow, this, what am I looking at? And it just all looked, dicey. And the thing is, it's not that I wouldn't trust a follower. It's just we have, if I broke something and I broke it wrong, boy, I would be in trouble. Yeah. So, it's one of those things. And it was so bad. I just couldn't believe it was real.
Right.
But it was. These people are awful. I mean, of course, these are the same assholes who took footage of an Italian hospital, right? And they've showed up. Twice. The first time, like, oopsie, are bad. And then they did it again.
Right. So
you think to yourself, okay, this probably wasn't an accident this right. time. It's just bad. And I know, you know, I think the more I say, hey, I'm shocked at how terrible the media is, the dumber I sound. But I keep thinking it can't get much worse. And what do you know? It does every time.
Well, you know, this was the network that had Dan Rather, so.
Oh, that's a good point. Dan Rather, the godfather of fake news.
Right. Yeah, the first casualty of internet, you know, crowdsourced fact checking.
Bad. Oh, I forgot all about that. Yeah, that's right. It's true. But they also have Catherine Herridge, who's done a fantastic job with reporting on things. Of course, the rest of the media doesn't want her covering and has anything to do with Obamagate. So, yeah, full circle there.
Mm-hmm.
But this also, I wanted to talk a little bit about what we're seeing on social media and in leftist circles about the idea that on one hand, they're telling people that Trump has killed an economy. This is, you know, they're not even pretending that this is something that they had to do or that was something that Trump didn't have a choice in. They're acting like he's deliberately let the economy die. So they're saying that he's killed the economy as well as he's killed 90,000 people, right?
Sure. Yeah.
This is not an and thing. This is an or thing, folks. You know, if he leaves the economy open, more people die. If he leaves the economy shut, then he saves people. I'm struggling with this. And what we're seeing is they're not even trying to pretend that they know. It's like they have no memory of what actually happened with the virus.
Well, and no, I mean, they're rewriting, not just rewriting history, but it's like, because they have the memory of a goldfish, they think everybody else does. And it's like they think that we don't remember what happened 2 weeks ago.
Yeah, they think that we're paying as little attention as they are. I mean, like today, Senator Brian Schatz, who I just like saying his last name, Schatz. Schatz was saying, hey, look at all these people Trump's killed, and he's killed his economy. This is the worst economy in our lifetime, and he's killed 90,000 people almost. It's like you don't understand the two are related, asshole.
Right. You know? They want to pretend that these are two entirely, you know, disparate events that, you know. All these people are dying and the economy is tanking, but they're completely unrelated because everything exists in a vacuum.
Everything is Trump's fault. And what this tells you, though, is that this has never been about saving lives or doing what's right for the country. And we knew that. But of course, when you talk about that, people, oh, look at you and your tinfoil. Oh, you're Q or you're a maggot or whatever. But the reality is, if they really cared about human life, they sure as shit wouldn't be saying, well, you fucked up, killed the economy, way to go, keeping those people safe. You know, it's one or the other. Either you're okay with what had to happen to save human lives, or you're willing to keep an economy and sacrifice more people. And someone else pointed out to me today, too, that it wasn't even Trump who really shut the economy down. He left that up to the governors to make those choices, because like Iowa, Nebraska, South Dakota, plenty of those economies didn't actually shut down.
No, and that's kind of the it's just such a disingenuous argument.
But that's all they've got, and that's what they're counting on in November.
Well, I mean, okay, if they were if they actually cared about any of this, and I know a lot of our listeners have seen me make this point a couple times, one-third of the total deaths in the United States happened in New York State.
Right.
So whose failure is that really? Because two times more people died in New York nursing homes than died in the entire state of California.
Yes.
You know, it's – and California only has two times more fatalities than the city of Chicago.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's just such – they're so desperate to make Orange Man bad that they have to look back. They have to completely ignore where these deaths are from and what caused these deaths.
And what we've been doing for the past 10 weeks.
Right.
And it's like even today, Cuomo was talking about how, some people are going to die. You know, he's making excuses for all these folks that he killed in nursing homes by making nursing homes take in sick and elderly people who could have been sick. Of course, he's a huge hero to the left in the media right now. But he was talking about how, well, these are old people and this is what's going to happen and blah, blah, blah. Can you imagine if Trump had said that? Or I think Rudy Giuliani is actually the one who did say, these are people who are dying. Bill O'Reilly said the same thing. These are not people who are like in the prime of their lives. These are people who are in their 80s and have had a great life. And he wasn't saying it was okay that they were dying. But they were saying, we're not shocked that these are the people who are getting hurt. And we're not shocked that they're the ones getting sick. So, but they got fricasseed, you know. Well, they're going to kill your grandma, you know, whatever, some shit.
Right.
Almost says that. It's like, oh, well, he's right. Old people will die, I guess. Boo-hoo, you know. I was like, holy shit.
Yeah, hey, we've gone from, it was like Red Steve said today. In the span of 1 week, we've gone from you want to kill grandma to grandma must die.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But before, that was what they were saying was our whole mantra was, we will sacrifice the old people because we're greedy and we want our money. So, yeah, we've, again, come full circle. Isn't that funny how that happens?
Yeah. Yeah. Well, when you have the memory of a goldfish, you can do that.
So we have the things that come from this show are Bigfoot erotica, licking doorknobs, tongue-kissing hobos, and the memory of a goldfish. Welcome to
fish porn.
And fish porn. God. I do want to talk about something really cool that happened today.
Okay.
And that is, and I know you have a couple things, but I want to do this one really quick.
Do I have a couple things?
Do you? I thought you did, but if not, this is cool. There's a gym in New Jersey called the Atlas. And as you know, New Jersey is pretty draconian. Everything's shut down. No gyms are open. Of course, no gyms are open in Virginia either. But the Atlas decided they were going to flip the bird to the state government, and they opened their doors today. Again, this is a small business. So I think they forget that gyms are actually small businesses too, and that they have to survive somehow. So they decided they were going to open today. And there's all these people there, and there's people up front, and the cops show up. And they come up, and they're like, well, you guys are in violation of state law, blah, 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 blah. So I have to tell you that, but I'm also going to say, that's it. Have a good day, and be safe. And he walked away.
That's awesome.
Nobody got arrested. He didn't set them down. Nothing happened. I mean, we found out later they were cited. But technically, as the law, they kind of had to do something since they were breaking the law, and really being cited is not the end of the world.
Yeah, I mean,
go to court, have your say.
Well, okay, and that's good. That's actually okay. That's actually what the cops should be doing: not taking down moms in the playground and arresting them and carrying them off, not locking up Karen at salons and, you know, hauling her to jail. You know, give the citation. And then when this is all done, when people can start going to court again, let them fight it. But it's almost like they, you know, because now, again, being a petty tyrant, you're eroding public trust. I don't think anybody would have a problem with these people being cited.
No.
I mean, it's dumb, but it's okay. You know what? Fine. It's the law. You got yourself a little traffic ticket there.
Well, and here's the thing is, you know, these policemen don't do anything, then they fired, they could lose their gigs, they could be written up. I mean, we're looking at consequences for not enforcing the governor's draconian stupid bullshit. So citing them, again, to your point, gives them a right to have their day in court and fight it.
Yeah. Or, I mean, that's going to happen if they take them to jail anyway. But, I mean, at least, okay. you lose the argument of, so let me get this straight, you're releasing burglars and murderers and everything else, so that way you can take in a guy who wants to open his gym so he can feed his family.
Right.
Yeah, this guy wants to open his tattoo shop so he can feed his family. And I'm sorry, but I mean, it's some, especially with tattoo parlors and like hair salons, and these are some of the most sterile places.
Oh, yeah.
All the time. Not absolutely. Just when there's a virus going on.
Right.
You know, I mean, it's aside from a mask, I've never gotten a tattoo where the dude wasn't wearing gloves and everything was sterilized. And
how many tattoos do you have?
Four.
I don't have any.
The
idea of ink on my skin, I have a phobia. True story. I don't like ink on my skin at all. Nah,
it's so cathartic.
If I get pen on me, I like panic. So, and it comes from when I was little, I drew all over myself. I was like 7. And my grandmother told me I had poisoned myself. So, trying to keep me from doing it.
Nothing like close relatives to give you lifelong psychosis.
Terrify the shit out of you. And that's why I can't even get marker on me or I have a shit fit. But no, you're good point. You know, these are places that are probably cleaner than any, you know, gas station out there that's been allowed to stay open. So interesting. Yeah. It was really cool. And their reaction when the cops are like, okay, have a good day. Thanks. You know, be safe. Have a nice day. And they walked away. The cheers and the American flags. I cried like an idiot when I read it and watched it because it was just this moment of, oh my God, they can do what they need to do. And I know it could have been just a leaky eye.
Yeah, you were leaking.
I was leaking. I wasn't crying.
But you were leaking with pride.
I was leaking with pride. Yeah, you're right. Leaking with pride. Oh my God. Oh, but speaking of pride. Yeah. So did you see the whole She-Ra thing?
Isn't this like the second time they rebooted? Didn't they reboot it already once back in 2018?
I don't know. I don't pay that close attention. But apparently rebooting She-Ra, and it's an all-female writing staff.
All woke, all the time.
All woke, all broads. And they're doing like this whole thing where, you know, they have women of all shapes, sizes, colors, and they have a lesbian. So, you know, it's really
And
important.
They have a gender fluid one, and it's the princesses.
Yes.
She-Ra yes. princesses.
Yes.
Whatever.
Because they want children to be able to see that gay love is okay, you know. Children. Okay. And hey, whatever, to each their own, live and let love or whatever, but my kids don't need to see that until they're
you know, it's not the first gay cartoon character. It's not even the first gender fluid cartoon
it
character.
It really isn't.
The thing is that we've talked about this so many times, is that when it is your agenda to do yes. this and it serves no purpose to the story whatsoever.
Yep.
Then you're just making shit. And you're pandering and offending everybody.
Let's just make it something that people want to fucking watch.
Yeah. And you know what? Like He-Man and all those things, those were, they all had a message in them. What the message was isn't entirely clear, but they always did have, you know,
right.
a message. There was a moral to the story that they were trying, but
right.
if you go into it with a full agenda, you're not giving a teaching moment. All you're doing is haranguing and you just nobody's going to watch it.
Well, and to your point, those cartoons, the bigger picture was something about bravery or, you know, tackling things you need to overcome or persevering or hard work or, you know, being good to people. It was very
brushing your
broad.
Teeth.
Yes, it was broad. It wasn't so make sure you're okay with gay love. You know, make sure you appreciate, you know, heavy women or short women or gender women. It was much bigger scope and it made sense for more people. And it didn't feel preachy. This feels preachy.
I know this probably hasn't popped up on your radar, but are you familiar at all with the Marvel comic, the new Warriors?
I don't know if I am or not.
Okay, they have two new characters, Snowflake and Safe Space. I'm not making it up.
What is it called?
It's the new Warriors. Uh-huh. Because they had the new Warriors, but these are the new Warriors.
Oh, good.
And yeah, so you have Snowflake and Safe Space, who are their colors are gender swapped, but they're not. The guy's wearing pink, and
oh
the
my god,
wearing blue.
And then
it's real. And it's funny because when Marvel released a video on it, it got like 2 million downvotes. And but you know, and this it's a giant middle finger to. It's like I said, when you have a good economy, you can afford to be woke.
Yeah.
You cannot afford to be woke right now.
No.
Okay, Netflix is going to shove a shit ton of money into this new She-Ra, and it's going to last as long as the last She-Ra did. Marvel is going to shove a shit ton of money into these comics with Snowflake and Safe Space and, you know.
Those are real names. I keep
thinking. Those are real. I'm not making it up. They talked about it on the Joe Rogan Experience a couple weeks ago, and he said, if you were to parody SJW culture with a comic book, this is the comic book you would write.
That's nuts.
But it's not a parody. And the people that they're trying to appeal to with it are also offended because they are being pandered to, and they can see it, and it's naked. And
They're being made into caricatures.
Yeah, and it's like there's another one there's another character that his grandpa was researching internet gas and experimental internet gas, and it got all over him. So he can, you know, immediately Total Recall memes and instantly get information off of Google and Google Maps. And it's just the most cringy, Gen Z fucking tripe pandering bullshit there is.
And you know all about it.
Well, yes. You forget I do a culture show too. So yeah,
you are all over the place.
I am. But yeah, the new She-Ra, it's going to fail.
It is. Yeah. Well, NPR actually was the one who did the whole article on it. So, you know, our tax dollars went to pay for an article on She-Ra that's being done with all of the SJW goodness you can think of. Yay, good times.
Yeah, you know what's funny is that I was actually, I had a narco-Marxist thrown into my timeline today who was actually using one of the cartoon characters. It didn't occur to me until after when I was researching this story. I said, that's who they have. Is the gender-fluid lizard-looking princess. It was her Abby. So I'm just like, oh, wow, that was quick because this thing just got announced like yesterday.
Oh, boy. So gender-fluid lizard lady. Well, good to know that we are trying to include our gender-fluid lizard people. That's important.
Yeah, Crow, you're not alone in that. I mean, the market, the comic book market has nosedived since they started doing the woke shit in 26, 28.
It's bad.
And it's only gotten worse. I talked about this on Culture Shift. It's like, okay, Marvel had a prime opportunity when they rebooted Iron Man and Spider-Man and all these things. You know, it's like they had this market going into comic book stores and, you know, it's like, okay, I want to get the Iron Man that has the Tony Stark. No, they have Ironheart. with Riri Williams, a black teen girl.
Oh, fun.
Yeah, yeah, so it's like, oh, God, you just missed opportunities.
Yes.
And so, yeah, and that's why comic books is dying as an industry.
And that's why you'd have a whole show you'd spend talking about it. Speaking of that, we're almost done.
Yeah, I know, right?
Look at that, a couple more minutes. Now, you do a Cyber Wars tonight?
Yes, we are doing a Cyber Wars tonight. We got all kinds of stuff on deck.
All kinds of stuff, and that's at 10?
Yes, that is in 1 hour. And I just saw Rick post in chat that due to technical difficulties, there is no for immediate release. So we've got a dead hour, and then Lou and I will be back with Cyber Wars.
Awesome. And then what else? We have FUBAR Wednesday night.
We have FUBAR Wednesday night.
And what else do you have?
And I believe this is a toxic masculinity week as well.
Fun.
And then I'm on Thursday with Brad for Culture Shift.
Wow, you are busy this week. Okay, so let's do this officially. Hey, Ordy, where can people
find you? Yes, Samantha.
Tell us where people can find you.
Well, thank you for asking, Samantha. They can find me next on Cyber Wars in 1 hour. And then on Wednesday, they can find me with another episode of FUBAR, One Nation Under Foo, with my lovely and smiling co-host.
And leaking,
Foo Bunny. And then afterwards, I will be on Toxic Masculinity. Robinson and Wright, I believe I'm still filling in for Dan because he is essential. And then on Thursday, I will be with Brad Slager on The Culture Shift. So Wednesday is actually the night of Ordy.
Oh, the night of Ordy. We'll have to call it that. You are our Hordy here at KLRN. And congratulations, you really are. Too funny.
Where can people find you, Samantha?
Oh, stop with the Samantha. That's so yucky. They can find
me. Is leaky eye yucky?
It's like worse than leaky eye. They can find me every Monday night here at 8 p.m. Eastern on KLRN Radio with this dork until at least everyone is in phase one across the country. Then we'll have to look at that. Every other Wednesday night at 9 p.m. on FUBAR, again with this dork. And then you can also find me on a little website called twitchy.com and, of course, on Twitter at PolitaBunny. That's PolitaBunny. That's a lot to talk about. We've gone
actually,
by.
Hang on. I've got a correction because for some reason, adding 2 days to 18 meant 25. And so Toxic Masculinity is next week, not this week. It'll be it'll be G in his all of his stunning Spartan glory on his own.
Him and his pecs. The Amish are not known for their math skills. It's okay. All right, guys, we are out of here. Thank you for being with us on this Monday night as we went through our FUBAR and sitting in chat, even though chat sucks. We will be back with you next Monday night at 8 p.m., but we'll also be back this week on Wednesday at 9 o'clock for our regular FUBAR. As always, we're so glad to be with you tonight. Thanks again. And until we talk, stay out of jail and keep your sense of humor.
If you prick me, do I not leak?
With the resurrection, is the group harder than an erection that shows no affection? They want to ban us on
nothing but the ghetto. Taking short steps, 1 foot at a time, and kept my head low. And never let go, cause if I let go, then I'd be spineless. I'm going insane.
I think my mind just goes out of control and touch on subjects motherfuckers freedom. I touch on the shit that they be leaving out. I seen this motherfuckers not smoking. I seen this, I bet you motherfuckers will too. Because it's time, motherfucker, die, motherfucker, steal, fool.
I think it's something in the water, man. It's got to be in the water.
Oh, fuck. Chips on the killing spree again. We're guillotine for men. I walk around town with a frown on my face. The whole world finna catch a murder case. The murder rate.
Make it crease if you caught up in the world while it's dying. I guarantee you fry, cause I...